This video was made possible by Brilliant. Learn complex topics simply for 20% off by being one of the first 200 to sign up at brilliant.org/HAI. Hey there, kiddos. I need to talk to you about something. It might be a little awkward, but it's important for you to understand. When two countries love each other very much, or sometimes hate each other very much, one of the countries will invade the other one. And it's perfectly natural, and it's okay, and it can be great, just so long as they plan for it, because the thing is, if you're not careful, sometimes invasions can happen by accident. Or at least, that's what happened in May of 2020, when Poland accidentally invaded the Czech Republic. This is Poland. It's called that because it's the land of Po, the red Teletubby who wanders through the country at night, kidnapping babies and turning them into the sun, and this is... Wait, what is this? I know it's a republic, but which one? Let me check. Oh, it's the Czech Republic. Good thing I checked. Now, both the Czech Republic and Poland are part of the Schengen area, a set of 26 countries in which you can travel freely without border control or passports. Think of it like Disneyland. Once you get into the park, you can go to any part of it you want. Fantasyland, Tomorrowland, Adventureland, Monetizing Nostalgia Land, Cash Grab Sequel Land, Corporate Consolidation Land, Ruining Star Wars Land, and Toontown. Who doesn't love Toontown? It's a town full of toons. The point is, anybody can cross from Poland to the Czech Republic, or the other way around, anytime, anywhere, no questions asked. At least, that's how things are normally, but things aren't normally at all right now. I don't know if you've heard, but there's some virus going around called something like the wear a mask, you selfish morons virus. Yeah, that last one sounds right. Anyway, because of that, countries have started to act on a provision of the Schengen Borders Code that allows member countries to temporarily close their borders, quote, in the event that a serious threat to public policy or internal security had been established. Now, I'm not sure how it's going to help to close their borders. I mean, borders went bankrupt in 2011, and to my knowledge, all the stores are already closed. They probably should have shut the Barnes & Nobles, but the point is that they can. A border closing can be enacted by an individual nation and cannot be vetoed by the European Commission, though the Commission does have the ability to issue an opinion on it, which does nothing, but people always feel better when they get to voice their opinion, even if it won't change anything. Speaking of which, leave a comment down below with your opinion on an Israel-Palestine two-state solution. Since COVID hit, a lot of EU nations have exercised their authority to close borders, including Poland and the Czech Republic. This meant Poland had to start doing something they haven't historically been very good at, protecting their borders from invasion. So they stationed soldiers at the border, including here, in Pierzymów, a Polish border town, but there's where the problem came. Every building in Pierzymów is in Poland, except for this church, which is in the Czech Republic, and also this house, for whatever reason. But the Polish soldiers were apparently too busy doing whatever Polish people do, pole dancing, polishing, Pilates, who knows, to realize that, so soldiers had stationed themselves at the church thinking it was the furthest point of the border in Poland. When Czech people came to their church in the Czech Republic, the Polish soldiers stopped them and they were like, hey, you can't come in here, this is Poland. Then the Czech people were like, no it's not. And then the Polish people were like, yeah it is, and also by the way, get out of here. Which meant that the Polish military was blocking citizens of the Czech Republic from entering a part of the Czech Republic, and when that happens, it's usually called an invasion, and it's what political scientists refer to as kind of a big deal. Eventually, word got back to the Czech Republic that they had been invaded, and so they went to the Poles and were like, hey, did you invade us? And the Polish people were like, I don't think so, but let me check. And then they checked, and the Czechs showed that they'd invaded the Czechs, basically putting them into a diplomatic checkmate. Ultimately, though, things turned out fine. The Poles said it was an accident, the Czechs believed them, and after a bunch of fancy official statements smoothing the whole thing out, things went back to as normal as things can be in 2020. Believe it or not, this wasn't the first time a country has accidentally invaded another country. Back in 2010, a Nicaraguan official noticed a Costa Rican flag flying over here, across the San Juan River in the Isla Potillos, which made him very angry. Not only because the Costa Rican flag has an insignia with writing in the middle of it, which is a terrible flag design, but also because he was pretty sure that that land belonged to Nicaragua. Just to be certain, he opened up Google Maps to check, and sure enough, the Costa Rican flag was in Nicaragua, and so he and 50 of his troops crossed the river, took down the flag, and stationed themselves there. Now, normally when Google Maps is wrong, it means I arrive late to my meeting of YouTubers who secretly fix the price of interesting factoids. No big deal, I'm just late. But for the Nicaraguans, Google Maps' mistake meant that they had just invaded Costa Rica by accident. Ultimately, to avoid war, both Google and the Nicaraguan government had to issue an apology, and the mistakes of big tech companies went on to never stoke global conflict ever again. If you want to work for one of those big global tech companies, or if you want to just learn how to code because it's a super useful skill, you should check out Brilliant, the problem-solving-based website and app that helps you achieve your goals in STEM learning. Learning new stuff can be hard, which is why Brilliant breaks down complex topics into easy-to-follow, bite-sized chunks that'll engage you with storytelling, coding, interactive challenges, and problems to solve. They've got a super wide range of courses, so whether you're hoping to brush up on geometry, build neural networks, write algorithms, learn a new coding language, understand machine learning, or something else, Brilliant's got you covered. Go to brilliant.org/HAI to sign up for free, plus the first 200 to sign up will get 20% off their annual membership.